Hey there, welcome to Play Noggin. I'm Julian, your Brains Player 2. This week, we're taking our first deep dive into Pokemon with a look at some of the most interesting and dangerous creatures the series has featured. Originally released in 1996 in Japan, Pokemon has gone on to conquer the world of video games. People on both sides of the Pacific and all around the world can't get enough of these pocketable monsters. The most recent releases, Pokemon Sun and Moon, take the series on a tropical getaway and introduce a ton of new Pokemon to collect, most of them being really slow for some reason. But that's not the point of this video. While even your grandma would love to have her own pet Pikachu, despite the fact that it would almost definitely interfere with her pacemaker, it's important to remember that Pokemon are, on the whole, incredibly dangerous creatures. If they really existed, some of these critters would have some pretty horrific implications for the world and the people in it. Let's just say you wouldn't be thrilled to adopt a Decidueye. This owl-like Pokemon is known for keeping its cool and avoiding trouble, unless you startle it, at which point it explodes into a violent panic. The Pokédex says it's capable of firing quills with such force and accuracy that it can pierce a pebble at a distance of over 100 yards. And all this happens within a tenth of a second, so if my calculations are correct, that quill is traveling 914 meters per second. Consider that a typical hunting arrow travels at approximately 84 meters per second and delivers 86 joules of energy. That's enough force to penetrate an animal hide and even some fairly sturdy plywood. This little bird can launch its quills with pinpoint accuracy in less time than it takes you to apologize for scaring it. Beware just wants to love and be loved. It expresses its love for you via its signature bear hug. It will be the last hug you ever receive. Beware is capable of lifting more than a ton with its super strong arms, and it doesn't know its own strength. Here it is, punching and hugging a tree in half, with ease. According to the Pokédex, many trainers have literally died from Beware hugs. That means a Beware is loving you with more than 3,000 newtons of force, which is enough to crack the human cervical spine. Translated, it'll snap your neck. That's the equivalent power of a quarter-ton car smashing into a wall at 30 miles per hour. And you thought your great aunt's hugs were awful. Our friend Terminator literally explodes. It's a walking bomb. The Pokédex claims the shell on its back is chemically unstable and will explode if struck. And it's not just its shell, but its dung too. Terminator is an exploding poop monster. Just let that sink in a minute. Should've called it Terminator. It's hard to guess exactly how powerful Terminator's explosions are, but let's start on the low end and imagine its equivalent of 1 kilogram of TNT. If you happen to be 11 meters or more away from Terminator when he blows his shell, you're probably fine, maybe some minor injuries from flying debris, but nothing fatal. At 2.7 meters, we're talking about bone fractures, bleeding, internal injuries, all around bad stuff. And at 1 meter or less, take all the above and add internal organs rupturing, concussion, and, at best, a lengthy amount of time unconscious. At that distance, death is a very real possibility. Suffice it to say, Terminator wouldn't be high on anyone's birthday wish list. Though, with the proliferation of exploding cell phones and hoverboards, maybe Terminator wouldn't be such a hard sell after all. Moving away from the realm of exploding animals and into the realm of razor-sharp animals, we have Kartana. This beastie's a bit different from other Pokemon in that it's an Ultra Beast visiting the Alola region from another dimension. We're told Kartana was once seen cutting down a steel tower with a single slice of one of its blade arms. Do we have anything that can even come close to that level of sharpness in our world? It turns out we do, kind of. They're called Damascus Swords, and they were originally used in the 8th century. Yeah, as in 1,300 years ago. Scientists have only recently rediscovered the method for making them. It's hard to believe 8th century folks could do this since they hadn't even figured out indoor plumbing yet, but they managed to reinforce their steel with carbon nanotubes, tubular-shaped molecules with a ton of carbon atoms, which are significantly harder than steel. Along with nanowires that contain cementite, this technology enabled the swords to be both strong and flexible. So could a Damascus sword go head-to-head with a Kartana? No, probably not. We're restricted to working with materials we can find in our own dimension. Its interdimensionality gives Kartana an edge in that respect. Jolteon is an oldie but a goodie, another Pokemon that's been around since Red and Blue electrified the world in the 90s. It looks like an adorable kitty dog fox thing, but watch out. Jolteon is capable of firing bolts of electricity up to 10,000 volts. So obviously, cuddling your pet Jolteon is a bad idea. The real question is, just how deadly would an attack from a Jolteon be? Well, in fact, the voltage of an electric shock isn't the most important factor in determining how dead we'll all be. To put it in perspective, say you just shuffle your feet across a carpet and touch a metal doorknob. The ensuing shock, which stings and isn't much fun, was around 20,000 volts. So for those keeping track at home, that's twice the voltage of Jolteon's attack. The real culprits are the amperes. Now what are those? If you think of voltage like the water pressure in your pipes, the amps would be equivalent to the flow rate, or how much water is flowing through. More electricity equals more likely to die. It doesn't matter so much how hard it hits you, just how much of it is there. It would only take 7 milliamps of electricity for 3 seconds to stop your heart. That's it. Now, because Jolteon is a force to be reckoned with, it's safe to bet it's packing more than 7 milliamps. Not to mention the fact that lightning strikes are drawn to it, according to the Pokedex. Lightning delivers upwards of 30,000 amps and a billion volts. So, steer clear of Jolteon, no matter how cute it is. Magmortar joined the world of Pokemon in Generation 4, and like all the other Pokemon in this video, it's horrifying. The whole line of its evolution, from Magmi to Magmar to the fully evolved Magmortar, just love fire. They live in volcanoes and can withstand heat up to 1200 degrees Celsius. Convenient because, in terms of heat, that's the high end of what lava produces. Magmortar launches fireballs that are almost 2000 degrees Celsius and are technically hot enough to melt its own arm when fired in large barrages. But Magmortar is considerably sturdier than you or me. Humans begin to experience pain from heat at just 43.8 degrees Celsius. First degree burns happen at 47.7, jump up to 60 degrees Celsius for second degree burns, and push it to 72.2 degrees, and your sad human flesh is destroyed on contact. And if literature has taught me anything, it's that wood catches fire at Fahrenheit 451. So, if you keep a Magmortar or a Magmar or a Magby as a pet, keep it away from forests or, you know, homes. The moral of the story seems to be, if Pokemon were real, they would utterly destroy the world. It's a good thing they're not and that we can enjoy them the way they're meant to be enjoyed. Now, we just focused on Pokemon found in the Alola region, but there will be more Pokemon to come. We've only just scratched the surface of all the weird and scientifically implausible creatures in these games. If there's a really dangerous Pokemon you think we missed and you want us to cover, tell us about it in the comments below. Pokemon's a mainstay of video games, but there's tons more, like, say, Minecraft, and what it can tell us about, perhaps, our very existence. Check out this video here for more on that. And don't forget to keep on playing.